God is in control.
Praise the Lord.
And when the Lord is in control, everything it is set. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Somebody say hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Praise the Lord. Before Christ was born, there are some things that happened before the Lord was born. I know that people are busy. People are busy preparing for Christmas. Somebody has taken maize to the mill. He has prepared unga. And he has gone further even to buy some what we call memeras. And he is preparing something that and he wants to celebrate Jesus.
Oh, naro ero bangete kwenge busa elinda sereke Yesu Kristo.
But really, all those are according to the mentality of human
beings.
Praise the Lord. Vana ashifiwe. Before Christ was born, there
are
some things that took place. And I believe God is going to speak to us this hour. Praise the Lord. There was a gentleman known as Joseph. The Bible said that Joseph was engaged to Mary. Praise the Lord. In the engagement, they agreed that they will come one time, they will get married. So these two people, they were bound in an agreement that they will be a husband and a wife. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
And because they agreed, let me tell you this. Covenant, it is under agreement between two parties. And these two parties, because they have put an agreement, this agreement has not, it is not supposed to be broken. Here comes Joseph engaged to Mary. They agree on one thing, that you are my fiance. And I want you to one time for you to become my wife. Praise the Lord. And according to the Jews,
Hello?
According to the tradition of Jews, whoever was engaged, she was supposed to remain virgin until the time she will get married. Come on, somebody say hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
And if it is a boy or a man, praise the Lord. When he enter into an engagement, he has to remain faithfully until the time of marriage comes. If you read the Bible in the book of Deuteronomy, praise the Lord. Deuteronomy chapter number 20.
Deuteronomy.
Praise the Lord. Deuteronomy chapter number
22-23.
Bwana asifiwe sana. Deuteronomy. Yes, Deuteronomy 22-23. Yes, there is something there. Deuteronomy 22-23 to 24. Can you read it, please?
Hello.
Deuteronomy chapter number 22, verses number 22 to 23. If a man is discovered committing adultery, both he and the woman must die. In this way, you will purge Israel for such evil. 23. Suppose a man meets a young woman.
Suppose a man meets a young woman. That is a virgin.
A virgin who is engaged to be married.
Yes, a virgin who is engaged to get married.
And he has sexual intercourse with her.
And he has sexual intercourse with her.
If this happens within a town.
If this happened within a town.
24. You must take both them.
You must take both them.
The gates of that town.
And to the gates of that town and stone them to death.
Yeah.
Amen.